أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه يستعين في جميع الأمور الحمد لله الذي يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه وصلى الله على محمد وآله ودعاتهم الذين بهم خلق هداه Worshippers of Allah Ta'ala, Ibad, Mumin, Mukhlisin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah subhanahu place you among the people who worship Him with sincerity, ikhlas, who supplicate Him in the manner in which He has commanded them in the Quran, seeking the intercession of His Awliya. Supplication is a form of worship. May you be among the people who supplicate continuously to Allah Ta'ala, thereby gathering provisions for the hereafter, before the day in which death stretches out his hands towards you. May you be among the people who supplicate and worship and build their home in paradise. We are always encouraged to supplicate Allah Ta'ala. The Quran Majid says, Ud'uni astajib lakum. Pray to me, do dua to me, and I will answer your prayer. Prayer, dua, is compulsory. So when a mu'min prays, does dua, how does he do so with full sincerity and conviction? What is the wisdom in sincere supplication? What belief should you hold when you pray, such that you obtain abundant blessings? I do this bayan with Allah Ta'ala's aid and His Wali Imam Zaman's ta'eed. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran Majeed, Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. Truly Allah Ta'ala has power over all things, can do any and everything. When you pray to Allah, the first thing to do is to strengthen your conviction, yaqeen. Your conviction that Allah is the whole and soul of all things and every blessing comes from Him. He is the giver of life. Imam Hussain salawatullahi alayhi in his supplication to Allah says, I exist because of you, because you gave me life. First and foremost, and you have continued to shower me with your blessings. For the future, too, I place my hopes in you. So a mu'min should also pray with the conviction that he is the humblest of Allah's servants. As Imam Zainul Abideen salawatullahi alayhi has taught us when he said in his supplication, I am the smallest of the small, aqallul aqallin, humblest of the humblest. I am like an ant or even more tiny. A mu'min should also pray with the conviction that Allah will hear his prayer. Allah Ta'ala himself has said that he is sami'ud du'a qareebun mujib. The one who hears all prayers, who is very close, who answers. And as Allah has said, Allah never breaks a promise. Inna Allah la yukhliful mi'ad. And Allah Ta'ala has made the promise that pray to me, I will answer you. So remember that He will answer you. A mu'min should also pray with the conviction that the doors of supplication are always open. As Imam salawatullahi alayhi said, to Allah, addressing Allah Ta'ala, Babuka maftuhun lis-sa'ilin. Your door is always open to petitioners. You should be confident that Allah Ta'ala knows what is in your heart. Open your heart and supplicate to Him. Tell Him whatever is in your heart. I recited the Quran ayat that Allah has power over all things. Imam salawatullah alayhi shows how to pray. He said, you should ask God, وَفَلْ بِنَمَا أَنْتَ عَلُوا فِي الدِّينِ وَالدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Meaning, do with us what you are worthy of doing in the realm of religion, in the realm of this world, and in the hereafter. For Allah will do what is best for me. That is what it means when you pray like that, with the conviction that He has power over all things. Mumineen, one should never think in arrogance that you, a human, have the power to do all things or even anything at all. Rather, you should know with full conviction that Allah Ta'ala holds the reign of all things. The author of Ikhwan Safa gives great insight about sincerity in prayer, in dua, at the time of dua, how you should be sincere when you pray. He says that total sincerity in prayer is achieved when a person is fully convinced that he can do nothing more by himself, nothing at all. Giving an example, that just when a person who is aboard a ship, when the ship rides into the most terrible of storms, and when he sees huge waves crashing down, he realizes that there is nothing he can do at this time. He will only be saved if Allah Ta'ala saves him. Everything is in Allah's hands. In such a moment, with this belief, this person offers the sincerest of prayers. This is the meaning of Imam's parable here. This example, Mumineen, believe sincerely that everything is in Allah's hands and pray to Him. In the last Majlis, I spoke of gratitude, shukr. Giving thanks to God strengthens your courage, because giving thanks is also a form of worship. And someone who gives thanks, all Muslims pray for his dua to be heard, for the person who gives thanks. When they say in their namaz, in prayer, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ, may Allah hear the prayer of the person who offers Him thanks. When you give thanks to Allah Ta'ala, He hears your prayers. Those who humble themselves before Allah Subhanahu, pray to Him, as I said above, pray with conviction. Do not become one of those who, when blessed with luxuries in life, sit astride the horse of arrogance. Do not be one who, in that circumstance, as the Quran describes him, turns away from God. أَعْرَضَ وَنَأَى بِجَانِبِهِ. But when he is touched by hardship, he makes long supplications. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ فَزُوا دُعَاءٍ عَرِيدٍ. A mu'min should know that his ability to pray to Allah Ta'ala is itself one of Allah's biggest blessings. That he is able to speak with Allah, that Allah has granted permission for him to do so. There are many things that you cannot tell anyone, but with Allah you can speak of all things. Imam Zainul Abidin's supplications are heartfelt and most powerful. Mumineen always recite them and avail of their blessings. Imam beseeches Allah that if you do not have mercy on me, if you do not do rahmat on me, then who will have mercy on me? Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَسِعَتْ رَحْمَتِي كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My rahmat, mercy, encompasses all things. Even if you have sinned or lost hope, made mistakes, always remember this, that Allah's blessings are larger than our mistakes and sins, and never lose hope. This is expressed beautifully in a verse in Arabic poetry, that my sins, when I think about them, are so many, but my Lord's mercy is larger than my sins. I will speak of istighfar, forgiveness, in another majlis. What is the wisdom in seeking Allah's forgiveness? A Muslim requested Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam to pray for him that he goes to paradise, to Jannah. Rasulullah answered him, A'inni bi kathrati sujood. Help me by making many prostrations. Sajda, meaning with God's worship and supplication. Allah Ta'ala's worshippers are closest to Him when they prostrate, when they do sajda. That is why our Mawali teach us to do sajda and pray. Pray with your heart, with conviction. And if tears fall from your eyes while you are praying, it is a sign that Allah has heard your prayer. Some people say that I prayed, but my prayer was never answered. Remember, Allah subhanahu has promised you that He will answer your prayer. Our Mawali relate that when a mu'min obtains reward in the hereafter, after his passing away from here, at that time, he will also obtain fulfillment of all the prayers that he made in this world that were pending answers. He will get those answers in the hereafter. At that time, he will say, I wish I had received all my answers and rewards here in the hereafter, because there all blessings are multiplied. A mu'min should hold this conviction that Allah says in the Quran, Allah will never squander the reward of those who do good. I have mentioned already that you should seek wasila, intercession, when you pray to Allah Ta'ala. Do dua with wasila. Rasulullah and Amir Mumin have shown us how to take wasila and pray. Ali did arz to Rasulullah for dua. Rasulullah took Ali's wasila and did dua for him and prayed to Allah. This is a well-known report. Similarly, when Ali prayed to Allah, he took Rasulullah's wasila. As Maulana Ali says in one of the poems, seek the intercession, wasila of the Prophet. All calamities will become light when you do so. So if you pray with the wasila of our Mawali, your prayers will be answered. Your wishes fulfilled. Allah's awliya are the doors of mercy, doors of rahmat, through which you can reach Allah Ta'ala. When you pray namaz, you face Baytullah, Kaaba, to worship Allah. When you supplicate Allah Ta'ala, Imam al-Zaman, who is the one symbolized by Baytullah, is our best intercessor. Take his name and then pray to Allah Ta'ala. Take his wasila and pray. And also remember this, if your Mawali, Awliyaullah, move their lips in supplication for you, you will be truly blessed. Utba bin Walid offered Rasulullah in Taif 18 grapes. And Rasulullah did dua for him. Rasulullah's dua. Allah, because of that, Allah Ta'ala made 18 da'is, 18 du'at come in Utba bin Walid's lineage, in his line. Sayyidina Ali bin Muhammad bin al-Walid. This is from his line. The first da'i al-Mutlaq. 18 da'is. The story of Ustaz Yuzar is also well known. He purchased the dua that the Imam had made for another and reached the highest of ranks. There are many bayans like this. In the previous majlis you heard, Sayyidina Taher Fakhruddin said, a da'i's prayer is always answered. Da'ini dua mustajab. That same Maulana Muqaddas, Mu'ayyad, recipient of Imam's divine inspiration, said for Bawadi Sahib Maulana Qutbuddin, that Khuzayman's dua is always answered. Khuzaymani dua mustajab. Mustajab dua. He showed Maulana Qutbuddin's high station with a clear indication. Bawadi Sahib Maulana Qutbuddin would always arz Maulana Burhanuddin Ridwanullahi alayh for dua. I have experienced this many, many times. Many times Maulana Brahmani's dua message would arrive in a telegram or in another form, like in those times there was fax machines. Fax message would come. Bawaji Sahib would immediately perform a sajda of shukr upon receiving this message, would prostrate in gratitude and would summon all of us, his family members, and tell us that Maulana Minam has bestowed dua for us. Everybody do sajda of shukr. Mumineen, Muminat, always, always supplicate Allah Ta'ala with sincerity. Maulana Taher Fakhruddin says in a qasida, your servant, your supplicant prays to you in sincerity, O Maulana. So answer his prayer. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that dua silahul mu'min. Supplication is the believer's best weapon. Rasulullah has also said, God loves those who beseech him continually. Ameen Mumineen has said that dua miftahur rahmah, supplication is the key which unlocks God's mercy. His rahmat is received. Prayer is so powerful. It is said that ad-du'a yaruddul qada. Prayer can push away death. Supplication is worship. It is the best form of worship. Our Mawali Tahireen have left behind a treasure of supplications. If you found rubies, emeralds, diamonds, jewels lying around you, would you not pick them up immediately? This treasure of prayers is worth much more. It will benefit you forever in this world and the hereafter. Make these prayers a daily ritual. Make it a regular routine, a habit. Not a single day should go by when you have not recited at least one prayer. I, Mamluk-e-Aal Muhammad, have given permission for many prayers, du'as, to be translated from Arabic and disseminated so that mu'mineen can pray and understand what they pray. They can connect with it more and gain more blessings. It is also related that when you pray, you should recite salawat on Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. And if you do, your prayers will be heard. I will speak of this wisdom as to why in the next majlis, inshallah ta'ala. I beseech Allah subhanahu by the hurmat, sanctity of Muhammad, Ali Muhammad, and their dua. Especially Maulana Abdi Ali Saifuddin, whose Urs Mubarak just passed. I take his wasila, and today, 15 Zil Qadatul Haram, Thursday, is the Urs of Sayyidina Zainuddin, our noble former. And I take his wasila and I pray for all Mumineen, Mamluk Ali Muhammad, and Imamul Zaman's Da'i. I establish Tayyib Imams, true Dawat. And as Bawaji Sahib instructed me, I do dua for Mumineen morning and night. Maulana Burhanuddin Ridwanullahi Alayhi used to pray for Mumineen always, and he would say that this is not a favor I am doing for you. It is my duty to do so. Mumineen, may Allah Ta'ala make you partners in all my pious du'as and prayers. May Allah grant me and you aid always to pray to Him sincerely. May He always keep Imamul Zaman's ta'id flowing towards His servant Mamluk Ali Muhammad, and may He grant me aid and victory because of it. Nasr-e Aziz and Fath-e Mubin. May Allah Ta'ala keep Mumineen, Muminat, in prosperity and happiness. May Allah fulfill all your wishes. May He keep the word of truth lofty and bring low the word of disbelievers. May Allah Ta'ala keep His true Dawat Hakni Dawat in his protection always. And may he join the happiness of this world with the happiness of the hereafter for all mu'mineen, mu'minat. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihi sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi al-tahirin. Wasallama tasliman muttasilan ila yawmiddin.
Ya sabah al-khamisah.